Prior to release 11.2.3, all filters on a dashboard were applied equally. With cascading filters, selected values are used to limit choices in subsequent filters. For example, a selected year would drive which related months are available as filter options. Cascading filters create a better user experience by allowing consumers to use hierarchies in data. In this video, you'll see how to turn on cascading filters, how cascading filters work, how to create cascade sets, and how cascading filters work with local filters in a visualization. For this video, I'm using the Hospital Admissions Executive Dashboard found in the Healthcare Industry Samples content. I've copied it to my content folder. I've put the dashboard into edit mode so I can start to add cascading filters. When I drop facility name and department on the two tabs, they're operating independently of each other. For example, when I pick the Children's Hospital, I still see all the departments. If I wanted to only show departments for the Children's Hospital where I have data, I have to turn on cascading filters. With the dashboard selected, I click Properties and the Cascading Filter Settings. I toggle the Cascade All Tabs filters. Now, with the Children's Hospital still selected and looking at department, I can see the obstetrics department is no longer there as there was no data for it. I can toggle Show All Values. Obstetrics appears again, but it's wrapped in parentheses, telling me that there is no data for that department. If I move department to the All Tabs area, I will not get cascading filters. And I can see this by obstetrics appearing with the Children's Hospital being selected. What I need to do is set up a cascade set. And this is done in the case where I have filters that exist in the same filter area. I add facility name to the cascade set, and then I add the department. And you can see they're both now surrounded by gray boxes. Cascade sets read left to right, so the value I select in facility name will constrain the values I see in department. With the Children's Hospital selected, I can see with the cascade set, obstetrics no longer appear. I do have that option as before that I can toggle Show All Values, and in this case, obstetrics will appear in parentheses. If I want to change the order of my cascade set, I can select an item and drag it. If I select a specific department, only the related facilities will show. I can drag and drop a new filter value into the middle of my cascade set if I like. Now when I select a department, obstetrics, now when I select gender, I can see that the obstetrics department only has data for female patients. The default setting for cascade sets is first to last. That's reading left to right when applying the filter. Both gender and facility name have the show all values toggle. Department, since it's the start of the cascade set, doesn't have that option available to it. If I wanted department to have the show all values option, going back to properties, I changed the cascade set strategy to multi-directional. Now I see the show all values in each one of the filters. Cascading filters also work with local filters on a visualization. Selecting the admissions by department and fields, when I drop age range on the local filter slot, I can see the age ranges have been filtered for the Children's Hospital data. This concludes the video on how to set up cascading filters in dashboards. Documentation for IBM Cognos Analytics with Watson is available online. The video description below contains links for topics covered in this video. If you would like to try what was demonstrated in this video, you will find the data in the samples folder in team content.